If you don't have an attorney available now, you will have the right to remain silent until you can consult one. Do you understand?
Yeah, I understand.
Now that I've advised you of your rights, are you willing to answer questions?
I am Mr. Gannon's attorney, and he will gladly answer your questions as long as I'm present.
Guys, this is something that happened 23 years ago. Now, this is a district attorney. Do we have to go with cuffs and everything?
Bo, we all know the rules here. They're doing what they have to do.
Yeah, well,
they have no choice, Bo, and neither do I.
This is wrong, Hank. You hang in, all right?
Hank, I'll reach out of this somehow, I swear, okay?
This way, Mr. Gannon.
Hank the Cannon Gannon?
Yeah.
Tim Nicholson, Assistant DA, Cook County.
Well, Nicholson, sorry I can't shake your hand. You've met Police Commissioner Bo Buchanan?
Yes, Commissioner.
You know, it's very funny here, Tim, but when we went over this so-called case of yours for, well, I don't know, the 1,000th time, we decided that there could be no charges, and now you're sort of throwing a murder charge at him at this point? Tim, please. Come on here now. Isn't there some other way you could do this without an arrest? I mean, after all, you did say that you knew Hank Gannon's reputation.
I'm sure your attorney informed you I've got an eyewitness. With the rest of the evidence, that gives me sufficient grounds. The charge is murder. I don't see any reason for Hank the Cannon Gannon to receive special treatment, do you?
Well,
listen, you mind if I have a minute alone with my attorney and Mr. Buchanan here?
Sure, no problem.
With the cuffs off, I'll take responsibility.
It's okay.
Well, I guess now's a good time for us to play our old favorite game, Double Dare. Cheer me up.
Oh, yes, sure. I can manage that. Let me see. Not only will I have you out of here in no time, but we'll be laughing about this all the way back to Pennsylvania. Huh, Tim?
Yeah. Okay, now who is the witness? Is it Danny Keller?
Well, who else was it, Juliet, with RJ?
This is bad, Nora. And you know, he's gonna try to stick me with this. We have no physical evidence, nor do we have our own witness to contradict him.
I know. The two other warriors that were in the room that night, they're both dead. I'm sorry. One of them in Vietnam and the other one recently for heart attack. I checked it out. We got nobody.
The state probably offered him immunity and then agreed to reduce some of his sentences for Keller's felony convictions.
Well, look, there's no love lost with me and Keller. But with RJ behind him, who knows what he's willing to say in that courtroom?
Well, maybe I'll make some phone calls and see what I can get on him. You know, I don't think it's going to be terribly difficult to discredit him with the judge.
Even if you break his story, they've still got the videotape from the surveillance camera.
Yeah, but we're going to throw that tape out as soon as my expert gets back with his report, Hank.
No, our best bet is to find that original tape, the one that shows you leaving long before that guard was shot. And RJ's got it. He's hidden it someplace. I could just feel it.
Well, I'll keep trying to find it.
Okay.
Listen, Nora, I want you to talk to Rachel and Sheila. I mean, if they're looking to come up here, I want you to talk them out of it.
I will take care of them. I know what you want.
Thanks. You never let me down, do you?
We're gonna win this.
Hank, I think it's a good idea if we go to them. I don't want them coming back here after you.
You got it. Let's do it.
Hank?
Thanks. I was just taking Ben to the hospital.
Just checking in. Can't wait to get back to work.
Have you heard anything from Daddy? Any news?
I've been waiting to. I've got something on the stove. I'll get that in the kitchen.
Okay.
Okay, excuse me.
Hope it is Hank. Sheila's more uptight than I've ever seen her.
Yeah, we all are. But Dad most of all.
You know, I can't imagine Hank not being the DA. I mean, he lived for that job, and now that... Hey, I'm sorry.
No, it's not you. Look, I know what I promised. I promised that I would stay away from RJ and the jail, but I went to see him. Ben, I begged him to tell the truth about Dad, but he won't do it.
Rachel, look, I don't want you anywhere near the man ever again. RJ's a con artist. You give the guy half a chance, he'll get right to you.
There's nothing he can do to us that he hasn't already done. He's practically ruined my dad's life.
Well, not yet. I mean, who knows, with any luck, they might throw it out or settle it.
Maybe.
Rachel, was that Dad?
Nora, you have any classes the next day or two you can't miss? I need you to go with me.
Did they charge him?
Yes. We need to get to Chicago as soon as we can.
Easy. I had to do some dancing to get you this phone again.
We made a deal, right? Two tickets for the Sixers, Saturday. Center court, fourth row.
Better be.
Trust me. It's a private call.
Make it fast.
Yeah, it's Gannon. Listen. Did you get that message to Joliet Prison for me? That's why I deal with professionals. Now, you did talk to Danny Keller personally, right? Good. Yeah, I've been waiting for this a long time. Yeah.
Here we go.
Oh, wow.
Aunt Clara's famous chicory coffee with chocolate shavings.
Oh, I do remember this.
Good. I made a whole pot.
Delicious.
Who's Danny Keller? I couldn't help overhearing you on the phone.
Oh, well, I'm very lucky to have some contacts still in this town. Danny Keller is the prosecution's star witness.
Says Henry was involved in the shooting.
Yes, but I'm going to prove him to be a liar.
Friends of Randall James always been liars and thieves. Randall James broke his mother's heart too many times. I'll never forgive him for that.
You were so good to us. I mean, Hank and me.
I wanted my nephew to be happy, that's all. Wanted you both happy.
Well, I thank you for that. For then and for now.
There's just one thing about you I never got, Nora. You and Randall James. How come you liked him so much? You were the only one helped him, defended him.
Well, maybe...
Maybe the boy had you under his thumb. That's what I think. Found a way, didn't he, Nora?
I was wrong about RJ, and I'm really sorry about that.
King of misery, that boy. We all got our stories.
Hey, something smells great.
Everything I make. Ready for some of my chess pie?
Yeah, and how about a big piece for Red here, too? That way we can celebrate.
Red? Who's Red?
Yeah, I think that your famous chess pie is the perfect thing to go along with a big chunk of great news.
What kind of news?
The best. Exactly what we've been waiting for.
A new beginning.
This is real business with opportunities for everyone.
Shattered by a shady past.
Are you sure that this partnership with Sonny is a good idea?
Will loyalties be questioned?
Do you have to go into a partnership with someone who comes with this much trouble attached?
Sonny didn't turn his back on me when I was in trouble.
That puts us in the middle of a war zone, doesn't it?
Will partners become rivals?
You don't want to get in the middle of this, Luke.
I am in the middle.
General Hospital, only on ABC Daytime.
What kind of news?
I just heard from my expert. He says that videotape that shows Hank at the scene when the gun went off, it has definitely been edited, honey, just like we thought. That's it! Case closed.
No, case is not closed, exactly. No, it's gonna damage the prosecution's case badly. But unless we can find the real tape, the one that shows it really happened that night, we can't clear Hank.
RJ might have burned that tape years ago.
Randall James holds on to everything, even a grudge. He's a pack rat.
Oh, I'm gonna get that because I'm expecting a call from the court. Don't you eat that whole pie, Bull Buchanan.
Looks great.
Taste it. This tape you've been looking for. He'd keep it right under everybody's nose just to prove how he'd gotten away with it. Wear the thing around his neck if he could, half hoping somebody would notice. He just loves feeling smarter than everyone else. How's my pie, huh?
Well, okay, come on. No time to eat. Come on.
No, it's time for this pie.
No. They just granted my motion. We're having the preliminary this afternoon. And Clara, we'll see you later.
Oh, good luck.
All right, thank you. Come on, come on.
Just a second. I swear this is the greatest pie I've ever tasted in my life.
Bo? You clear, Henry. I'll make you a dozen.
You're on.
Bo?
Yeah.
Dr. Ben, I heard about your little accident. I'm glad you made it.
Here to congratulate you, RJ. Finally got what you wanted. Oh, you still haven't heard the news. Hank's been arrested for murder.
What a shock.
What a crock.
Well, I don't know, Doctor. Do the crime, do the time.
Right. And you think it's over? You think you've won?
Won? What? My brother's life in ruins?
May take some time, but there's a way. Something even you haven't thought of. And one of us is gonna find it.
Well, we all have our dreams.
Stay away from us, RJ. Last warning. You got me?
I got you. I got you good.
Gannon! Let's go. Your lawyer's outside. Your arraignment's in 10 minutes. He says he's gonna have you back on the street in an hour.
Don't let me rush you. Get used to the place. So I've got a feeling you're gonna be visiting somebody in prison real soon. And when you do, give Brother Hank my best, will you?
Well, judge should be here any minute.
Why don't we just go in and sit down, honey?
No, not yet.
Why not?
Hank, sweetheart. Hi, Daddy, are we too late?
No, you're right on time.
Are you okay?
Yeah, baby, I'm fine. I'm gonna be fine. And you, I should have known. You never do what I tell you.
Hey, you've carried this thing around on your own long enough, Hank. You're not alone anymore.
Thank God for that.
Counselor?
Nicholson?
The Judge Cutter is on his way down. He likes to start on time. Everybody in place? Gentlemen?
The judge likes to start on time. Gentlemen?
Yeah, well, give the judge what he wants. That's my motto. Well, I'm about as ready as I'm gonna be. Inside?
Right behind you.
Right. Hey, Rachel.
I have never hated someone so much in all my life. My Uncle RJ is the sickest man I have ever met.
Yeah, but look, your dad is one tough guy.
And Mom is the best, I know. I don't even know why I bothered to try, you know?
Try?
To talk to RJ. In jail this morning. He hates Dad so much. He showed me this medal. From when there were kids in school, my dad won some spelling bee. RJ stole it. He keeps it like some kind of trophy.
I'm surprised you didn't try to steal those trophies at, during the case, the trophy case at school.
Bo, what is it?
I don't know, Rich. I just had one of the strangest ideas that I've ever had in my entire life.
A way to raise your kids without yelling, without hitting, and timeouts. Next open.
Well, I know we celebrated last night, Hank, but there's no reason why the four of us can't get together and do it again. All right. 30 minutes. Great. Bye-bye. You're sure about this? I mean, you haven't, like, changed your mind or anything, right?
No, not a bit. No. Have you?
I asked you first.
Well, no. Honey, you know, we agreed. I think it's time that we set a wedding date. And, I think we should really make it official. I think we should make a public announcement.
I think so, too. I mean, I thought you were going to say something when we were at Vicky's house, you know, today, to Vicky.
Well, yeah, honey, but, you know, she was, she was dealing with Sloane's death,
yeah.
You know. I didn't want to. What'd you think? I got cold feet and I just backed off or something?
Well, I mean, it kind of occurred to me that...
Well, you could have talked to her.
No, no, it wasn't my place. And besides, you know, she didn't need to hear about how happy I am today. She needed a hug.
Yeah. She's not the only one.
Oh, boy. I don't know what I'd do if I lost you.
Honey, that's never gonna happen. Ever. I mean, you're stuck with me. Forever.
Vice versa.
Come on.
I told Hank and Sheila, you know, 30 minutes from now. Well, hell with them.
The dream is...
Get Hank and Sheila coming.
Well, they got a fireplace, too. Maybe they're home playing toasted marshmallow just like we are. You know? They've got a lot to celebrate, too, thanks to you.
Oh, no. You were the real hero.
I was just doing my job. You're the one who went above and beyond the call of duty. I mean, there's not too many ex-wives that would do something like that for their ex-husbands, you know.
You're not jealous by any chance, are you?
Jealous? Me? No, absolutely not jealous. We're talking about a totally secure guy here.
Yes, he is.
No, I'm talking about me, not Hank.
Oh, you. Oh.
when you and Hank were married, mm-hmm. Did you two joke around as much as we do? I mean, you know, no jealousy implied.
We had our share of laughs, you know, still do.
Must have taken something pretty serious to make the laughing stop.
Well, I think it always takes something pretty serious to break up a marriage, especially when there's a child involved.
What was it? What came between you and Hank?
Things, you know. Just a lot of really foolish little things.
What?
What?
What are you smiling at?
You're a good kisser.
Okay, really? Well, thank you very much.
I shouldn't have told you that. Now your head's gonna get all swollen.
Guess that would affect my kissing ability, Dan. Whoa. I got news for you, though. Red?
What?
You're a good kisser, too. So now your head will swell, and it'll match my head. It's swell, and it'll just be swell. Right?
Thank you. You know, just the little things like that, you know, like... Oh, my God. They're here.
See, we got ready in record time, didn't we, honey?
They'll never know that they, interrupted anything. Coming! Hello!
Hello.
Hey. Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Well, well. Hi. So, are we, interrupting something?
No, why would you think that?
Well, you know, Nora, a good lawyer is trained to be observant. I rest my case.
Oh, thanks, Hank. You know what? I was just looking for that thing.
Well, I hope you guys like extra cheese, because... What are you doing bringing the pizza? We invited you.
Yeah, I know, but listen, we've got something to celebrate, so I figure that we should pay for the party.
The state attorney general called Hank this morning.
Yeah, in light of what happened at the hearing, he refuses to accept my resignation. Which means that you are now looking at a man who is once again employed.
Oh, that's wonderful, Hank.
That's great.
Thanks.
Congratulations. Oh, great.
Well, we have something to celebrate, too.
Yeah?
You do?
Nora and I decided that we're getting married.
What?
Well, you mean like, I do, you will? When? That's great.
When? When's a big day?
Well...
Well, we haven't gotten that far yet.
Okay, well, fine. Don't worry about a thing. Sheila and I will be more than happy to help you with that. We know you two, all right? And we know you're gonna need a little bit of help from your friends, or you will never, ever set a date.
Sure we would, right, Red?
Sure.
Come on. Look, you guys can talk about getting married all you want, but you're both too chicken to set a date.
Look who's talking. How long were you guys engaged before you set a date, huh?
Well, at least we set one. Hank's birthday. And it's coming soon.
Well, we're gonna set one, too.
Hmm. When?
When are we going to do that, Red?
Soon.
Yeah, soon.
You're right, Hank. They definitely need our help.
What are you going to do to help us plan our wedding?
Stage a sit-in.
What?
What are you guys, the wedding police or something?
Hey, you heard the lady. Now, we're not leaving this castle until you set a wedding date.
Honey, I just had a crazy thought.
Well, I get them all the time. What was yours about?
About where the real tape must be hidden.
What?
You stay here, okay? Just stall. Just
no.
Whatever happens, you just keep stalling, and I'll be right back.
But where are you?
Wish me luck.
I'm the one that needs the luck. I need that.
All right. Now let's get started.
This isn't a football game. Seats. I hereby call to order this preliminary hearing on the matter of the state of Illinois versus Henry Gannon.
Here you go. So what are you celebrating?
My freedom. They had me locked up on some trumped up charges, but now I'm free as a bird.
Great. How about another?
I wish I could. But right now, this bird is flying to Chicago.
Business?
Yeah, family business. I've got a loved one who's in a heap of trouble, and I want to be there to make sure everything works out just right.
I hereby call to order this preliminary hearing on the matter of the State of Illinois versus Henry Gannon. Now, this is a hearing to determine whether the defendant shall be held over for trial in the shooting death on November 12, 1972, of Francisco Valdez, a security guard at Midwestern University in Chicago, Illinois. Does the district attorney have a copy of the complaint?
Yes, I do, Your Honor.
I'll just take a moment to review this.
What happened to Bo?
We got a last-minute brainstorm about where RJ might have hidden the original surveillance tape, so we went to go check it out.
Yeah, well, he'd better hurry. It may be the only thing that can get me off the hook here.
My problem is, how do I stall for time?
Mr. Nicholson, are you ready to present your evidence?
I am, Your Honor.
Your Honor, I'm sorry. I'm going to ask you to put a halt to these proceedings immediately.
Gannon, would you mind explaining why you find it necessary to interrupt before we've even begun?
Well, Your Honor, I feel this case is unique. And I feel I must establish the social and political context in which this incident occurred. And if I don't do that, then I feel that a grave injustice will have been committed today on my client.
Your Honor, I don't know what the defense is up to,
but
must we...
Come on, Mr. Nicholson. I mean, you cannot deny that November 1972 was a time of political turmoil on college campuses all across this country. There was a war raging in Vietnam. There were people who felt it was unjust and even illegal. And there were students taking action everywhere, of various kinds, and Henry Gannon and his friends were four of those students. They called themselves the Warriors, and they were determined to fight against an unfair and oppressive policy. And so, on November 12, 1972, they broke into the office of the president of Midwestern University. Their mission, to obtain a secret list of names of African-American student activists that the university had been supplying to the FBI.
Your Honor, the issue here has nothing to do with the university's position on campus radicals, nor does it even have to do with the break-in itself. This issue only has to do with murder. An innocent man was shot and killed in that office, and the state has sufficient evidence to indict Mr. Henry Gannon for the murder.
Your Honor, in order to serve my client, I feel I must speak out.
You have spoken out, Miss Gannon, and I'm sure we've all benefited from the history lesson. The state may now proceed to introduce its evidence.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Well, no one can say we went down without a fight.
You're not going down. I'm going to stretch this thing out forever if I have to.
It won't matter if Bo doesn't find that tape.
He will. He has to.
Oh, come on. Somebody's got to be in there. What's going on here?
I've got to get inside the school. It's really urgent.
My school's closed for the day.
Look, I'm Commissioner Bo Buchanan, okay? From Landview, Pennsylvania. That's why I have to get inside to check something.
You got some kind of warrant or something?
No, I don't. But
well, I can't let you in. Can't let anybody in after hours. Come back tomorrow.
No, is this Henry Gannon Junior High School?
Yeah, sure it is.
Okay, if you don't let me inside, Henry Gannon's life is going to be ruined. He's going to go to jail for something he didn't do.
Now, do you want that to happen?
Hard to believe a young man who won all these awards could have killed someone.
Yeah, well, he didn't. And I have a hunch there's a piece of evidence in there that'll prove that he didn't. That's why I need you to open this case.
I don't follow. How can an important piece of evidence like that be in here?
All right, do you remember Hank's brother, R.J.?
Huh. R.J. is not the kind of kid you could forget. What a troublemaker.
Well, he's even worse now. I believe that R.J. had a videotape that proves that Hank was not there when that security guard was shot. I think that that tape is right in here.
How do you figure that? Why in the world would he...
It's a stretch, but you've got to understand the way R.J.'s mind works. This would be the perfect place to hide the one thing that gives him power over Hank Gannon.
Right out in plain sight, huh?
Look at this. Look, right here. Somebody's tried to pry this open recently. Can you see that? Look at that.
Ooh, all right. If it's gonna help Hank Gannon, I guess it's worth a shot. I just hope you can find what you're looking for.
Yeah, so do I.
Call my first witness, Your Honor, Mr. Daniel Keller.
Oh, Your Honor, I vehemently object to this witness.
On what grounds?
Daniel Keller is a convicted felon on several counts. He is currently serving a life sentence for murder. His credibility is highly questionable at best.
The court will decide that, Miss Gannon. Now, if we may proceed...
Before we proceed, Your Honor, I feel it's only fair that the district attorney must disclose exactly what kind of deal he's struck with this witness. On what basis is Mr. Keller so magnanimously deciding to come forward?
There's no secret going on here, Your Honor. Mr. Keller has been granted immunity in exchange for his testimony. As far as his credibility, that's not at issue here.
Really? When is a witness's credibility not...
Miss Gannon, please. Need I remind you that this is not a trial? We are only here to determine whether or not the defendant should be brought to trial. It's common practice in this state, Miss Gannon. Or has it been so long since you practiced law in Illinois that you've forgotten how we do things here?
I haven't forgotten a thing, Your Honor.
Good. Then may we...
I feel it is unconscionable, however, in any kind of proceeding, not to take into account the personal record of an esteemed public servant like Henry Gannon. I mean, I certainly don't need to remind you of the work that Mr. Gannon has done in this very city, first as a police officer while working his way through...
This is absurd. It's obvious that the defense is engaging in some sort of tactic to stall these proceedings. I beg the court to contain Ms. Gannon and allow me to introduce my first witness.
Oh, Your Honor, if it pleased the court...
It would please the court if you would refrain from any further interruptions, Ms. Gannon. Is that clear?
Yes. Yes, it is.
Not bad.
Are you kidding? If I tried to stall anymore, he would have thrown me in jail. Where's Bo?
The state again calls Mr. Daniel Keller.
Who is this Keller guy?
Unfortunately, he's a friend of your Uncle RJ's.
Oh, God.
Hey there, old buddy. Long time no see.
And you were a member of this group?
Yeah, I was a member. We called ourselves the Warriors. The name was Hank's idea.
By Hank, whom do you mean?
Hank the Cannon Gannon. The guy sitting right there.
And would you characterize Hank as the leader of this group?
He was the leader. He was the one that put the group together and then asked me to join. Now, most of us, we were only in it for the kicks. Being a warrior was cool. Chicks dug it. But Hank, he was in it for blood. He would have done anything to further the cause. You know what I mean?
This is a pack of lies.
Your Honor?
Miss Gannon? I have warned you before.
I just need a moment with my client.
A moment, that is all.
Thank you, Your Honor. I gather none of what he's saying is true.
Not one syllable. I didn't start the group. I was no leader.
Hell, half the time I had to ask these people what was going on. This guy is obviously under RJ's thumb.
Oh, great. RJ's not even here, and he's screwing up the good guys.
Yeah. Tell me about it.
You just stay calm. I don't need you displaying your delightful temper around in here. I'll try and unravel his testimony and cross-examination. Oh, my God. Your Honor, I implore you to remove this man from this courtroom. His sole purpose of being here is to upset my client and to disrupt these proceedings.
Your Honor, I apologize if I've disrupted anything, but I was under the impression that these were public proceedings. Now, no matter what anyone else thinks, I'm only here as a concerned member of the defendant's family. I care what happens to my brother, and I want to be here with him, with the court's permission, of course.
You have the court's permission.
Your Honor... He's not even...
Miss Dannon, I will not warn you again to refrain from these repeated interruptions. Mr. Nicholson?
Thank you, Your Honor. Thank you. Now, you said that Mr. Hank Gannon, that it was his idea to break into the president's office. What was the alleged purpose of that break-in?
Well, I thought it was to find that list and then get out of there.
Did anything else happen to make you think there was more to it?
Well, as soon as we got in there, Gannon and the other guys start tearing the place upside down, wrecking it. I mean, they were doing more than looking for something. They were really into it. They wanted to destroy the place, knocking over file cabinets, smashing furniture. And I tried to stop them, but they were too riled up, especially Gannon.
And then what happened?
Well, the security guard must have heard us, because the next thing I know, he's in the room. And then Gannon pulled out a gun.
And tell the court what happened next.
Gannon pulled the trigger.
Are you sure about that?
Well, I have no doubt about it. I saw Hank Gannon shoot that security guard.
That's a lie! Mr. Gannon, I'm warning you. Another outburst like that won't be tolerated.
He's a liar, Your Honor. He's a liar.
That's enough. Miss Gannon, advise your client he is not the prosecutor in this case.
He is very well aware of that, Your Honor.
No further questions, Your Honor. He's all yours, Miss Gannon.
Mr. Keller, you seem very confident of your recollections of November 12th, 1972.
It's hard to forget a night like that.
Mm-hmm. I would imagine. So what time was it that you broke into the president's office?
I told you. It was at night.
Ah, night time. Right. Could you be more specific? 9 o'clock? 10 o'clock?
I don't know. It was late. We weren't exactly thinking about the time.
Oh, I see. Then could you describe the vehicle that you used to drive to the president's office for us, please?
A car.
What kind of a car? Was it a large car, a small car, an old car, a new car?
I don't know exactly, okay?
Okay, all right, I see. Well, then, surely you can remember what the president's office looked like. Would you mind describing that for us?
Objection, Your Honor. What's the relevance?
Your Honor, this witness claims to remember some aspects of that night. I merely want to see how accurate his memory is.
I'll allow it.
Thank you, Your Honor. Could you please describe the presidential office for us?
It looked like an office.
Well, come on, Mr. Keller, I'm sure you can do better than that. What color were the walls? Carpeting? You said furniture was smashed. What kind of furniture?
Look, I don't remember all the stupid details. We're talking about a long time ago.
That's right, Mr. Keller. We're talking about a very long time ago. So long ago, in fact, that you could forget one basic fact, that Henry Gannon was not even in that room when the gun went off. Come on, Danny. The truth. Did you honestly see Hank Gannon shoot that guard?
You heard me. I saw what I saw. Hank Gannon's a killer.
further questions.
You may step down. The state may proceed.
I have no more witnesses, Your Honor, but I do have a crucial piece of evidence. A copy of a Midwestern University surveillance tape from November 12, 1972, taken by the warriors at the scene and retained by Mr. Daniel Keller. Your Honor, when you view this tape, you will see the events from that night unfold from the moment Mr. Gannon and the others enter the office all the way through to the shooting. Now, the gunman, Mr. Gannon, is not in view at the time the shooting occurs, but we do have the witness's testimony.
Your Honor, I object to this tape. I have an expert witness that will prove
as
that that tape is doctored.
As you are well aware, Miss Gannon, you will have every opportunity to bring forth all the witnesses you like if and when this case goes to trial. And may I have the tape, please? Now, we'll take a short recess.
Your Honor, this tape is
false. I have warned you several times, Miss Gannon.
All right, yes, I know, Your Honor, but I feel that it is my duty to at least ask for one last request from my client.
If this is another stall tactic...
No, I only have to say one thing. Your Honor, if this case does go to trial, I am confident that my client would be ultimately vindicated. But nevertheless, there's trauma and turmoil and character assassinations that accompany all kinds of murder trials, and that would be detrimental to my client, a man who has dedicated his life and his career to upholding the law. I urge you to consider this case in light of Mr. Gannon's life as a public servant, and to consider it with compassion and leniency.
I assure you, Miss Gannon, I will consider all the facts. This hearing is now in recess until such time that I have examined the evidence.
Gave it my best shot.
Oh, you sure did. And you were right about one thing. It would be a shame if this case ever went to trial.
Get out of my face, RG.
Oh, now don't worry, bruh. No matter what happens, you'll always be number one in my book.
Nothing here.
Yeah, this one's empty, too.
Well, that was the last of them.
Are you sure?
Yep. We've been through them all, twice.
Well, that was a long shot, but I was hoping I would be right and that thing would be in there. Without that tape, Hank Gannon is going to have to stay in trial.
That'd be a shame. You see, kids in this school, they need role models like Hank Gannon. They need heroes.
Hank really is a hero, too, isn't he?
Yep. After he graduated, they retired his number.
Yeah. Hank Gannon, number one. RJ is a zero. RJ Gannon is even lower than a zero. Wait a minute.